Figazi here, and I have a package that just arrived on my doorstep from FedEx, from Nashville, from KHS, i.e. Hohner Harmonicas. And I got two treats. We're not going to play with that today. But also, this is an unboxing of the brand new Hohner Golden Melody. And the trick with this is, it's a pretty radical redesign in terms of what it looks like. Obviously, I haven't played it yet or opened it up yet. That being said, I feel like this is a reboot harmonica instead of a sequel. So maybe the Hohner Rocket could be considered a sequel to the Special 20 or the crossover to the Marine Band. I would say this is more like a reboot though. The equal temperament tuning and the red comb might be the only things that are really the same, but let's find out. A lot of speculation about this for the better part of a decade. The box it comes in has Rachel on it, which is awesome. It's a very cool box. It's a smaller box than we've seen in recent years. It has what appears to be a cardboard case. It's kind of heavy duty. Looks pretty. And then here it is. It's still cold. It's just, I'm in Minnesota. This just came off of my doorstep from FedEx. Look at, you can see the condensation there from just bringing it inside. So I was a longtime Golden Melody player starting out. I had Clint Hoover and Chris McCulloch as teachers and started buying Golden Melodies early 2000s and was trying to get them to overblow and overdraw, and then eventually I'm more of a Special 20 / Rocket guy. So I have some of my older Golden Melodies side by side here. Dick Schoberg taught me a lot about customizing. He's a Swedish player. And so this is one of his special design pink ivory combs. There's only a couple of these in the world. And another Golden Melody I pulled out is a special Mike Figazi from Matt Smart and Hetrick harmonicas from back in the day. What makes this harmonica cool is this is the one I used on stage with Blues Traveler quite a few years ago. So let's get back comparing and contrasting an old Golden Melody with the new. So the comb is hugely different. It's embossed on the back. I'm seeing this all for the first time. It feels very lightweight. It is a different material, I think, or a different texture anyway, than the original combs that came with them. It looks like it's glossy in the front. It's smooth. And then this is more textured on the sides. Has a very unique back cover plate. Interesting decision to have the middle of the harp actually closed. It looks cool, looks very modern. The front, we see the same design with the covers that go into the slots on the reed plates, and the reed plates protrude more like a Marine Band. But the way it's designed, if you can see it up close, is it's very smooth. And it looks like the comb was designed so it recessed, is maybe the right word, right there, if you can see that. And you can kind of pick up the gloss on the front. Cover plate on the cover. All right. And I got to find the right bit here to open up the covers. So I'm excited to do that. My prediction was that they were going to use punches and dies that they already had for this. So very unusual that the covers must be, I believe that's a number 7 star bit. No, I haven't played it yet. That's what everyone wants to know, right? All right, and the cover plate screws are a lot like you see on some of the Marine Bands, except it's a different bit. And when you take the cover plates off, looks like they actually, I don't know how well that picks up, but they sit into the slot. That's what keeps them together. And this is what the reed plates look like. That's the blow. And that's the draw. I happen to have an open special 20, so it looks like it has a unique amount. These actually do look like they're unique for the Golden Melody. Designed for the reed plates, just with the number of screws. I could be wrong on that, I don't know. Here's what it looks like taken apart. You can kind of see that. So very unique comb. It sits flush on the comb. I'm not going to take it all the way apart because I want to give it a try here. So I do have a stock Special 20 and a stock Rocket Handy 2. I'm trying to see. Okay, it looked like if I put the blow plate on, the blow cover on first, that lined up. So with the right tools, with the right screwdriver, seems to go okay. Let's see how it plays. It feels great. The side by side, it's actually a little longer than an original. Pretty close when you stack them. And might be a little thicker too. So it's a little bit bigger. It does feel very comfortable. But definitely feels weird in my hands. Is a new harp. Let's see. Here's a Rocket. This sounds, I know it's going to be hard to hear, but it sounds a little mellower. This feels a little snappier. I think very, very similar. Similar sound. This one's maybe a little mellower, maybe a little darker is a way to describe that. This feels like it's more, this feels like tighter in a good way, like it feels more isolated. I don't want to say this feels breathy, it doesn't, it's not leaky at all. So I love Special 20s, but they're definitely warmer, more muted sound. So playing it is more like a Rocket than a Special 20. Like just the tone that I hear, you probably can't hear any of that. And my first impressions are positive. And I'm definitely more of a melody player, so equal temperament is great. I grab stock harps. I usually tune mine similar to a crossover, a Golden Melody anyway. So I like it. I don't know how well the comb's gonna hold up. This is definitely a reboot. It does not feel like a Golden Melody. I got one here in a different key. So I was expecting to maybe be so-so, but this is kind of a neat harp. I like it. I'll probably get a couple more. It looks really cool from the back. So the covers, the comb, we'll see how they hold up. It is not preferred that they have these on the side, but I also understand logistically how that works. I would recommend. It feels different than a Gold Melody, but I like the feeling. This looks cool. It's a little weird, but I don't hear a difference. I like it.